Hi, and welcome to the fourth video in my cable management series. In the first few videos, we discussed the problems with having a large mass of cables dangling off of the back of our telescope, as well as the foundation to secure everything to the top of our telescope and power management. In this video, I'm going to discuss briefly data management and all of our devices that we use in our telescope for astrophotography run on USB. And so it makes sense to use a USB hub like this to manage all of the data. You can plug in several different USB devices and just have one USB cable that runs into your laptop or your computer of sorts. So with this little USB hub, I'm able to manage all of the data in and out of the cameras through just a single USB cable. And maybe by now you're starting to see some of the benefits of the cable management. With the rig runner power supply from the last video, we just have one power cable going in and we split that out to many different devices. With this USB, I have just one USB cable coming in and I can split that out to many different devices. So the power and the data components are now being managed by only two cables, and then they split out to all of the other devices that will be mounted up here or on the back of my telescope here. And we've now cut down on the cable clutter that is hanging off the back of our telescope. So I'm going to start by going over where this fits in my rig, how I attach it, and we'll start running some of the data cables in and out of here to kind of give you an idea how I manage all of the data cables and then some of the power cables as well. In the second video, I had shown you how I put together this Losbandy dovetail and bolted it on to the tube rings using these standoffs to give me some clearance. Also, I explained what the Velcro here, up here, under here is used for to hold different accessories in different configurations. So the first accessory that we want to put on our telescope for the time being is going to be our USB hub. Which is a 7-port USB hub with one USB 3.0 port in the back and a DC power to come in the... This is a powered USB hub, and I would recommend using a powered USB hub for the purpose of if you have any USB devices that require their own power supply, then that's one thing, but sometimes devices like to draw their power from the USB ports, and so to power 7 devices through a single unit like this, it makes sense to have your own power in. It also makes the data coming across the USB ports a little bit more reliable. The data is less likely to attenuate over a data cable. So again, a powered USB hub is really ideal. And I chose to go with the USB 3.0 because some of the devices I have are 3.0 USB. And I want to be able to take advantage of those speeds, and using a 2.0 hub would just make the USB 3.0 roll back to a 2.0 standard in my cameras like the ASI 174. So I've got a piece of Velcro on the back of my 7-port hub, and there's a piece of Velcro down here, and literally it just slides in and Velcros on just like that. And again, it's a little loose. One of these days I might actually tighten that up a little bit, but for the purposes of what I'm doing, the little bit of play that this gives me is not as bad as having all the cables I had shown you from the first video hanging off the back of my camera, or off the back of my telescope, sorry. So by having it Velcroed here, I actually have just enough clearance for my USB to make it through the tube ring, and I may have to adjust that. On the other side is where the power cable connects in to. Let me swing this around. And so here is my power in, and again I've got clearance around the tube ring. And this is because of the standoffs, I'm able to put this here. If I didn't have these standoffs, this USB hub would not be able to fit between the plate and my the focuser of my telescope. So the first cable I'm going to plug into my USB hub is the power cable, and that has a standard RCA or coax style DC plug, and as discussed in the power management video, I have a 5 amp power pull connector that would go into my rig runner. So this simply slides into the 12 volt jack right here, and I have the cables bound up, a lot of the slack has been taken out because ideally somewhere along here is where I'm going to be plugging in, and so I really don't need that much cable. So I've twist tied everything together and bundled it up nice and tight so I don't have a whole bunch of cable to deal with. From this angle, you can see all 7 USB ports are easily accessible and are obstruction free from anything that would be mounted here on the back of my telescope. The next item that I'm going to plug in and get ready to go is my focusing system. And that sits right on top here. Get that. And with that industrial grade Velcro, that is not going to go anywhere regardless of the orientation of the telescope. As discussed in the first video, I need a 12 volt power supply that plugs into my focuser, which is this cable here. There's also a USB to serial cable that plugs into the focusing system. And so what I'm going to do is plug in my serial here and my USB here. That USB superposition, it doesn't matter which angle you try, it's always going to be wrong. So now, theoretically, if this were plugged into my rig runner, I've got power for my focus system, and I have a way to get data from my focusing software to control my focus links. This is the cable that would connect my focuser here to the output port here. And as you can tell, this distance is not 6 feet, but I've got a 6 foot long Ethernet cable. This is a lot of cable to have to carry around for such a short distance. Fortunately, smaller cables exist. All I need is something short that'll get the job done. And in this case, I have a 1 meter or 3 foot just Cat 5. It doesn't have the extra shielding that Cat 6 has, but it's also flat, which means it's extremely flexible, and because it doesn't have all that extra shielding, it's lightweight. So what I can do with this cable is plug one end in here, and the other end goes in up here. And I can just run the cable like that. And now I've got the USB controlling my focuser, and my focuser now routed here, and I don't have 6 feet of heavy, stiff, blue, ugly mess. I've got a much more tidy looking, more flexible, better suited for the purpose of just controlling a focuser cable. So with my rig runner attached, I can take one of the power cables here, which I've labeled with a 5A for 5 amp. This is my USB, requires a minimum of 5 amps, or a maximum of 5 amps to run. You can see that I got the red and black. I've got red and black. There's only one way to plug that in. Presto. I now have power being supplied here if I had a actual electric cable coming up from the ground into the DC in. The first time I put this together, I realized that I had a whole bunch of basically free real estate in here. And it has a benefit of being over the center of gravity of my OTA and centrally located in the horizontal plane of the telescope. I can fit all of my cabling into this void, and I don't have to worry about the cables moving and dangling. Another thing is that the cables in here are going to be packed together fairly tightly, so they're going to prevent each other from wanting to shift around since they're going to be bunched together in such a tight confined space. So I don't have to worry about the mass of the cables offsetting the balance of the telescope. And I'm going to show you how I route all of that now. Starting with the DC cable for the USB, I had this kind of undone a little bit, but we can actually tighten this coil back up considerably, like so. And stash the cable in here like this. And we'll leave a little bit dangling down to come back up and plug into the rig runner. For the dew control, we just run that through and take this bundle of cable and stash it up in here like that as well. For the USB, thread this through like this. The power cable that I use for my SBIG camera can go ahead and go in here even if I'm not using it. I can still take advantage of being able to store the cable here and not have to take things off and route it every time I need to use it, like this. And now I've got some cable storage as well. The 12 volt DC cable, I actually route through here, like this. And so now all of my power cables are stored in here, and I will do the same thing with all of my data cables as well. So all of my power cables are now routed through the inside, and I don't have a whole bunch of power cables dangling down. I just have a nice, orderly, easy to see what's going on cabling system here that should be fairly simple to manage going forward. Thanks for taking the time today to watch my video. I hope you've learned something new, and I hope you've been inspired to get under the stars and take a look at something through a telescope. If you like what I've been doing, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel. It'll be a great way for you to show your appreciation, and it's the best way to be notified of when new videos get uploaded. Thank you, and clear skies.